Okay, pre-trip inspection, front of the vehicle, form A. Clearing slice in the top of the cap. Properly mounting secure, no missing lens, amber color, clean and properly working. Windshield, no crack, chip or broken, clean, properly intake with the rubber seal. The registration inspection up to date and visible. Wipers, no missing. Hood, lock and secure both sides with the lock latches. Grill, properly installed to the hood with the hardware. No crack, chip, and the protect the radiator. Assembly lights, low high beam. No crack, chip or broken, clean and properly working. Turn signal lights, forward flasher lights and marker lights. Amber color, no missing lens, clean and properly secure, no loose. Bracket of the convex mirror, properly attached and secured to the hood with the hardware. No crack, bent or broken, no missing glasses and clean. Front bumper, properly mounting secured to the frame with the hardware, no missing. No crack, bent or broken. License plate, visible and clean. Underneath of the engine, no puddle in the ground, no leaking engine oil, antifreeze, steering fluid or transmission fluid. The level of the vehicle is not leaning left and right. If any problems, is low pressure in the tires or the suspension is broken. We're gonna open the hood. All right, we'll continue to the passenger side, engine compartment. Alternator, bell driven, properly mounting secure to the engine with the hardware, no crack, bent or broken. Wires is properly connect, no looseness, corrosion and clean. Water pump, bell driven, properly mounting secure to the engine, no visible leaks. We have to check the serpentine belt, no fray cut, all loose, and the tension of the belt should be between half to three quarters of an inch. General overview, all rubber hoses and the wires. Properly connect both ends with the clamps. No abrasion, bulges cut, no visible or audible leaks. Continue to the driver's side. We have to mention driver's side, same thing. General overview, all rubber hoses and the wires. Properly connect both ends with the clamps, no abrasion, bulges cut, no visible or audible leaks. Air compressor, it's a gear driven, properly mounting secure to the engine. Main airline, tight and secure, no audible leaks. Power steering pump, it's a gear driven also, tight and secure to the engine, no crack, bent or broken, no visible leaks. Cooling reservoir, tight and secure to the bracket with the hardware. No shifted or loose, no visible leaks, cup is present, no broken crack or chips, or no visible leaks, level between min and max. Steering fluid reservoir, tight and secure to the bracket with the hardware, no signs of the leaks. Level visible from the side, should be between min and max, cup is present, no broken or loose or missing. Oil level dipstick, just a verbal explanation. I have to take it off, wipe it, put it back, take it again, make sure the level is refill or mark. Steering wheel shaft, free play, no more than 10 degrees. No twisted, bended, cracked, secure both end with the U-joints, lubricated, no missing any parts. Gearbox attached to the frame, no missing hardware, no crack, bent or broken, no signs of the leaks. Pitman arm, drag link, upper control arm, lower control arm, and a tie rod, all parts not twisted, bended, cracked, properly connect and secure with the castle nuts and cutter pins. Suspension system, spring leaves. No shifted, scissoring, crack, bent or broken, tight and secure, both end with the spring hangers. Spring hanger attached to the frame, no missing hardware, no crack, bent or broken, no illegal welding repairs. Two U-bolts, tight and secure to the saddle and to the axle with the hardware. No shifted, rusted, crack. Shock absorber, no hydraulic leaks in the portion area, no bended, tight and secure both end with the hardware and rubber bushings, no dry rot. Air brake hose and ABS line, tight and secure both with the clips, no abrasion, bulges cut, no air leaks. Air brake chamber, tight and secure to the bracket with the hardware, no missing. C-clamp is present, no loose or rust, and no crack, bent or broken, no air leaks from the chamber. The push rod and slack adjuster. When you release the brake, push rod should be moved no more than 1 inch free play. Push rod, no bended, no missing clevis pin with a cutter pin. Inside the wheel, brake lining, no less than 1/4 inch thickness. Brake drum, no crack, bent or broken. Between lining and drum, no oil or debris. Inside the rim, no crack, bent or broken, no illegal welding repairs. Inside wall of the tire, no bulges cut. The tires at the top, the thread depth, no less than 4/32 inch. Evenly worn, no recap, virgin tire, and should be properly inflated, manufacturer spec of the tire. Outside wall of the tire, no bulges cut. Rim outside, no crack, bent or broken, no illegal welding repairs. Lug nuts, no missing, losing, rust, no shiny threads, which is indicate the looseness. Hub seal, no missing hardware, no signs of the leaks. Air valve, the metal cup present, no missing, no air leaks. You have to check pressure by air gauge. Pressure should be manufacturer spec of the tire. Coupling system. Step to the catwalk and catwalk. Properly mounting secure to the frame, no missing hardware, no crack, bent or broken, no grease clean, and should be hold weight of the driver. We have three lines: red, emergency airline; blue, service airline; green, electrical line. All lines is good enough slacking for turns. No touch any parts of the truck. Airlines, no abrasion, bulges cut, no air leaks. Properly connect and secure to the truck with the fitting and to the trailer with a glad handle. No air leaks and rubber seal inside, no damage. Green light, that's electrical, no abrasion cut. Properly connect and secure both end with the lock latches. Electrical box properly installed to the headboard, no missing hardware, no crap, chip or broken, and no visible burning spots. Then we have to check coupling devices. The mounting plate properly installed and secured to the mounting bracket with the mounting hardware, no shifted, loose or cracked. The platforms, both sides properly attached and secured to the mounting plate, no missing hardware, no crack, bent or broken, no illegal welding repairs. Fifth wheel, properly attached to the platform with pivot pin and cutter pin, both sides. Release handle should be fully locked position when the trailer is present. Skid plate of the fifth wheel, properly greased. Apron of the trailer, no crack, bent or broken, no illegal holes, and should be straight. Between apron and skid plate, no gap. We have to check in the back of the fifth wheel. The locking jaws has closed around shank of kingpin. Kingpin of the trailer, no crack, bent or broken. All right, we're gonna start the pre-tip inspection inside the cab. First of all, we have to check the floor. Should be clean, no debris, no any foreign objects under the pedals. Seat for the driver should be properly adjusted and feel comfortable. Seat belt, it's a mounting secure to the wall, no missing screw, and condition of the seat belt, no cut, ripped or fried. Lock latch on, off, on, working properly and properly adjust to the driver. Windows, both sides of the door, properly function. No crack, chip or broken, clean. Mirrors, properly adjust to the driver, no missing glasses, no crack, chip or broken, and properly installed and secured to the bracket. Windshield, no crack, chip or broken, clean. Rubber seal around the windshield, no ripped and no visible leaks. Inspection registration up to date and visible. Bracket of the wiper arm, No crack, bent or broken wipers, no missing wiper blade properly attached to the windshield, no cut and ripped. We have to check the turn. We turn the key to ignition mode, check the ABS, truck and trailer, on and off. System is working properly. Steering wheel, free play, no more than 10 degrees. CD and highway horn working properly. Turn signal lights, indicator and dashboard, turn to the right, turn to the left. Forward flasher lights on is working properly. Turn the switch for the headlights on. And the high beam, which is indicated the blue color on the dashboard, is working properly. Wipers, we have to check the intermediate, low and high speed. And when we're pressing, the wiper should be working with the washer fluid. If it's not working, we're gonna add the fluid. Then we have to check the climate control. Turn to combined position, defrost and the heat of the legs. Turn the heat on, turn the fan on. Air blowing top and the bottom, system is working properly. We have to check emergency equipment. Fire extinguisher, properly tight and secured to the floor, fully charged up to date on the green section of the display, and the protection pin in place. Three reflective triangles on the red box should be properly folded, no broken or chip, and should be stand by itself. Spare fuses in a gloves compartment or to the fuse box. Now we have to demonstrate safety start. Parking brake is applied position. Transmission neutral. We apply the foot to the service brake and start the engine on. So we're gonna build up air pressure up to 120 psi. Governor should be cut off the air. We're gonna hear the sneeze sound. All right, system fully charged, 120 psi. Now we have to check the air brake leak test. Engine off, turn the key to ignition mode. You apply the foot to the service brake and release parking brake, truck and trailer. You have to wait when the air pressure stabilized. We have to count exactly 1 minute. So make sure they're gonna be zero. You have to be flip over and wait. All right, we not lose more than 4 psi per minute, no leaks. Next test, we have to check low air pressure warning device. We're fanning brake pedal and drop the air pressure around 60. Buzzer and warning light should be on. Buzzer and warning lights on, system is working properly. Next test, we have to check emergency spring brake. We're gonna drop the air pressure between 40 to 20. The parking brake valves automatically pops out. S- system is working properly. We started the engine, build up air pressure again up to 120 psi. Press the gas. We have to check the all gauges. Water temperature gauge, normal operating range between 170 to 200 Fahrenheit, no warning signals. Oil pressure gauge between 30 to 60 psi, no warning signals. RPM, up and down needles is working properly. Speedometer we will check when we check the service brake. The odometer shows the exact mileage of the vehicle. Voltmeter, normal operating range between 12 to 14 or the blue zone of the gauges. Fuel gauge indicates the level of the fuel in the fuel tank. And air pressure gauges, primary and secondary, normal operating range 120 psi. И стоим, ждем, пока набьется это давление в системе. Alright, system fully charged. Now we have to check the parking brake of the vehicle. We apply the service brake, put it the drive and release parking brake of the trailer. Press the gas. Vehicle is not moving. Parking brake of the vehicle, hold it and working properly. Then we have to apply the parking brake of the trailer and release the tractor. Press the gas. Vehicle is not moving. Parking brake of the trailer, hold it and working properly. Then we have to check the hand valve. We apply first and release parking brake truck and trailer, press the gas, vehicle is not moving, hand valve, hold it and working properly. Then before we check the service brake, we have to build up air pressure again up to 120 psi. Parking brake you apply, neutral, release the hand valve. System fully charged, we have to check the service brake and speedometer. We're gonna move 50 feet forward for 5 miles per hour. Speedometer is working properly. Gently press the brake. My steering wheel not moving left and right more than 1 inch. We stop straight. Service brake is working properly. Parking brake, neutral. We're gonna build up pressure again to follow the next step of the exam. Thank you for attention. We're gonna start the pre-trip inspection. Form B, or side of the truck coupling system, and the back of the trailer. We started the bracket of the mirror, properly attached and secured to the door with the hardware. No missing, no twisted, bended, cracked, no missing glasses, and all mirrors clean. Open the door to check the door hinges. Properly tight and secured to the frame of the cab. No missing hardware, no crack, bent, or broken. Weather seal properly attached to the cab. No cut, no rip, or missing. Grab handle tight and secure, solid. Window rolling down and rolling up, working properly. Door lock and door latch, we're gonna close, open, close. Door is working properly and secure. Steps to the cab, properly mounting, secured to the bracket, no missing hardware, no twisted, bended, crack, no grease, clean, and should be hold weight of the driver. Battery compartment, battery cover, properly attached and secure, both sides with the lock latches. Inside all batteries, tight and secure with the clamps or brackets, and all connection and cables, tight and secure, no looseness, corrosion, and clean. Coupling system. We have to mention step to the catwalk, three lines, and coupling devices. You come back and explain the frame. Frame should be straight, no bended, no illegal holes or welding repairs. Cross members of the frame properly secure with the hardware, no missing, no twisted, bended, crack. Drive shaft properly mounting, secure with the brackets and the U-joints, lubricated, no missing parts, and the drive shaft, no twisted, bended, crack. We have to check suspension system. Mounting spring, properly mounting, secure to the frame, no missing hardware, no twisted, bended, crack, no illegal welding repairs. Spring leaves, no shifted, scissoring, or crack, or loose, tight and secure with the brackets. In the middle of the suspension, we have the two U-bolts tight and secure to the saddle and to the axle with the hardware, no shifted, bended, crack. Torque arm, tight and secure with the rubber bushing inside, no shifted, bended, crack. The dually wheels, the tires should be same size, evenly worn, and the thread depths no less than 2/32 of an inch. Maybe recap or virgin tire. Sidewall of the tires, no bulges, cuts. Between tires, no garbage or rocks. And the butt spacer, no space between rims. Outside of the wheel. Rim, no crack, bent, or broken, no illegal welding repairs. Lug nuts, no missing, losing, rust, no shiny threads, which is indicate the looseness. Axle seal, no missing hardware, no signs of the leaks. And we have the two air valves, outside and inside of the wheel. The metal cups should be present, no broken, no air leaks. You have to check pressure by air gauge. Pressure should be manufacturer spec of the tire. The bracket of the mat flap, tight and secure to the frame, no missing, twisted, crack, and DOT reflector tape should be visible, clean, and no rip. And the mat flap, no splitted, and no dragging to the floor. The rear lights. Turn signal lights, forward flasher lights, braking lights, and marker lights, red color. Reverse is a clear color. No missing lens, clean, properly working, and properly attached to the bracket. License plate should be visible, clean, secure with the hardware, and the light of the license plate properly working. So we have to check air brake system. Air hoses and ABS line tight and secure with the clips. No abrasion, bulges, cut, no air leaks. The dually air brake chamber, tight and secure to the bracket. No crack, bent, or broken. C-clamp is present. No loose, no rust, and no air leaks. Push rod, and slack adjuster. Free play, no more than 1 inch when you release the brakes. Push rod, no banded, no missing clevis pin with a cutter pin. Inside the wheel, The brake lining, no less than 1/4 inch thickness. Brake drum, no crack, bent or broken. Between linings and drum, no oil or debris. We're coming outside. And we have to mention a couple items on the passenger side. The fuel compartment, fuel tank, no crack, bent or broken, no visible leaks and no puddle on the ground. The straps, which is called the fuel tank, the metal and rubber, no crack, missing, ripped or loose, tight and secure with the brackets, with the hardware. The fuel cup, chain and seal should be inside, tight and secure, no visible leaks. We have to check the exhaust system, the muffler and pipes, tight and secure to the frame with the brackets. All C-clamp tight and secure, no missing hardware, no loose or crack, and no visible illegal holes or black soot leaks. And the beginning of the engine, the exhaust pipe properly connect, no missing hardware. Also, we have to mention the back of the trailer. Clearance lights in the top, red color, no missing lens, clean, properly secure with the hardware and should be washed properly. Back door, lock and secure with the lock latch, no missing hardware, no crack, bent or broken. The door, properly attached and secure with the hardware. On the door, no missing holes, no missing rivets, no visible holes, and should be open and closed properly, and DOT reflector tape. Visible clean and cover 50% of the door. Lift gate, lock and secure, properly folded and no visible leaks and DOT reflector tape, visible clean and no ripped. The rear lights, turn signal lights, forward flasher lights, braking lights, red color, no missing lens, clean, properly secure with the rubber seal and properly working. License plate, visible, clean, secure with the hardware and the light of the license plate. Should be properly working. Form C or the trailer. Started with the coupling system, step to the catwalk, three lines and coupling devices. And then you started with the trailer, headboard of the trailer, no holes, no damage, no missing rivets. Clearance lights, front and side, amber color, no missing lens, secure with the rubber seal and should be washed properly and clean. Sidewall of the trailer, no holes, no damage, no missing rivets. DOT reflector tape, properly located in low position of the trailer, visible, clean, and should be covered 50% of the trailer. Side rail of the trailer, straight, no bended, no missing rivets. Under the trailer, we have to check the cross members all the way to the end. No shifted, bended, cracked, or loose, tight and secure with the hardware. Wood floor, no visible illegal holes. Leading gears, full erase, all supports of the leading gears. No shifted, bended, cracked, or loose, tight and secure with the hardware. Crank handle located in the properly position. No bended or missing. Between mat flap and leading gear should be good enough space for turns. On the side of the trailer, we have turn signal lights, forward flasher lights, marker light, amber color, no missing lens, secure with the rubber seal and properly working. Air brake system on the trailer, air hoses and ABS line, tight and secure with the clips or clamps. No abrasion, bulges cut, no air leaks. The dually air brake chamber, properly attached to the bracket. No missing hardware, no twisted, bended, cracked, and C-clamp is present, no rust or loose. The push rod and slack adjuster, when you release the brake, they should be moved no more than 1 inch free play. Push rod, no bended, no missing clavish pin with a cutter pin. Inside the wheel, the brake lining, no less than 1/4 inch thickness. Brake drum, no crack, bent or broken. Between lining and drum, no oil or debris. We have to check suspension system. The mounting trailer arm, tight and secure to the frame with the with the hardware, no crack, bent, or broken, no illegal welding repairs. Shock absorber. Shock absorber, no hydraulic leaks in the portion area, no banded, tight and secure bolts, and with the hardware, rubber bushings, no dry rot. Airbag or air bellow, fully inflated, no air leaks, tight and secure to the top and the bottom with the hardware. Then we have to check the dually wheels. Tires should be same size, evenly worn, and the thread depths no less than 2/32 of an inch. Sidewall of the tires, no bulges, cuts. Between tires, no garbage or rocks. And the butt spacer, no space between rims. Outside the rim, no crack, bent, or broken, no illegal welding repairs. Lug nuts, no missing, losing rust, no shiny threads, which is indicate the looseness. Hub seal, no missing hardware, no signs of the leaks. And the air valves, outside and inside, the metal cups is present, no missing, no air leaks. You have to check pressure by air gauge. Pressure should be manufacturer spec of the tire. The bracket of the mat flap, properly attached to the frame, no crack, bent, or broken. Mat flap, no splitted, no missing, and no dragging to the floor. The ABS light, amber color, properly secured with the rubber seal, no missing, and any problem with the brakes, lights is on. In the back of the trailer, marker lights, red color, no missing lens, clean and properly working. Back of the trailer, clearance lights in the top, red color, no missing lens, clean, properly secure, and no missing hardware. The back door, lock and secure with the lock latch, which is no crack, bent, or broken. Handle is present, no missing with the hardware. On the door, no holes, no missing rivets, no missing parts, and should be open and closed properly, and DOT reflector tape, visible, clean, and cover 50% of the door. The lift gate, properly folded, lock and secure, no visible hydraulic leaks, and the DOT reflector tape, visible, clean. License plate, also visible, clean, secure with the hardware, and the light of the license plate, properly working. Turn signal lights, forward flasher lights, braking lights, and marker lights, red color, no missing lens, properly secured with the rubber seal, clean, and no missing. Also, we have to check the passenger side of the trailer. We're gonna be inspect the same way like the driver's side.